Welcome back to my channel. Today I will show you how to develop mobile app with ComfyUI and React with backend code Python and deploy in app stores. I searched YouTube, no video available. So I decided to share my experience with ComfyUI community. I will use ComfyUI Flux workflow, backend Python code and React Online to connect ComfyUI workflow and deploy it to physical mobile via QR code for testing this app. This will be 3 parts video and today is part 1 of 3. Watch the video till end so you not miss any steps to learn. The first things you have to do is open Flutter Flow website from your browser. You have to register in this website. There is free plan that you can use also for this app. Sign in via Google or other login option they provided. I will use my existing Google login here and I am using Pro plan as I have many apps deployed here for sale in the marketplace. Once you finish this tutorial you will be able to develop such app link with your ComfyUI and sale it here in Flutter Flow or App Store to earn big money via subscription plan offered to your clients. I have 4 apps here but I will use Flask app for this demo as my backend is Python. You can create your new app from plus create new button in top right corner. Double click to open it on the Flash app mobile icon, it will open the project for me. This will take some time to open the design interface of Flutter Flow to show your project. Here is a simple mobile app screen I design. Top part have title bar of your app. Next I give an option to type text to image prompt. After typing prompt user will click on generate image button. After that it will connect our server, in my case it will local machine where ComfyUI server is running on port 8188 and execute the Flux workflow via backend Python code and post the prompt to ComfyUI server and pass the generated image URL from backend ComfyUI server to React mobile app to display the image. This is whole process in short. If you don't have knowledge how to design React front end, then follow some tutorial online. The left part of this interface have many drag and drop control and right part is mostly used for setting properties and action means events. As we are using ComfyUI workflows API formatted version, so API call is main here while post and get the request and respond. If you start working with this interface you will more familiar. You can also include custom code here for more control on your app for customization. Have many icon there in the left panel, try to check one by one and gradually you will get an idea what is the purpose of those icons and what they doing. Whenever you click on any control on design area it will show properties related to element or control in the right side. If you copy the entire page style to other page also by copy the each page of your mobile app. There is also some action which is same like event while we are coding manually. I will show how it's look and how to add action and how you know if any elements have action attached or not from an existing app like I am showing now. If you open action flow editor it will give you option for add action, add conditional action, loop and parallel action here. In the next part 1 we'll show you how to set the property values and its purpose. I designed the entire interface here only by drag and drop the controls from left side panel. Flow of adding control you will clearly understand in the later part of this video. Before I proceed for details explanation I would like to check my ComfyUI server and test the existing Flux workflow and try some prompts to generate images locally. After that I will show you again how to set the control properties here in Flutter Flow. So far easy right? I already installed ComfyUI portable version in my local computer. If you new to ComfyUI just follow my channel and tutorials to learn more. Update your ComfyUI is always recommended. I have NVIDIA 3090 24GB GPU with 128GB RAM in this server, so I will open ComfyUI by run NVIDIA GPU batch file. It will take some time to open your server. I am using Windows 11 OS here. If you using Linux then start your sh file to start the server. For AMD GPU users Linux is recommended as driver is easily available in Linux platform. Now my ComfyUI server is start loading and the require nodes will be loaded for run the workflow. As I mentioned before I will use my existing 4 steps Flux workflow and workflow I already shared in my other video of programming web app with ComfyUI and I will share the link of those videos in the description below. This is a very basic workflow of Flux with only 13 nodes and as I have already some default prompt so let's try to run the first prompt by clicking on Q button. First it will load the models and then execute the text to image prompt value to generate the image. I will try 2 prompt here from my own 100 prompts I created by my own. After few seconds the results will be come out as image in save image node. Let's try another prompt by copy paste from my notepad and paste in the prompt area. This is one of good prompt that I used to share in other platform also. It will follow the same process to generate the next image. I want to make sure server is working perfectly locally so while making this demo tutorial there is no problem in the next part while writing and executing the code. If you like my channel please subscribe my channel, share my video link and don't forget to give a like and press bell icon to get the notification whenever I will upload next videos. Let's run this prompt by pressing Q button again and wait for output image. This time it will execute the workflow more faster as all models already loaded. After waiting for 15 to 20 seconds it will show the image. Processing is more or less done now and it's saving image now. 2 seconds more. Here is the output image. Now ComfyUI server is running perfectly, so I will go back to the Flutter Flow interface again to show the controls properties and action and how to set it. Very easy till now, right? Let's close this workflow and start working with Flutter Flow, where I will show you how to set the parameters for call ComfyUI workflow API via backend Python code post and respond to get back the image URL via internet. I used Ngrok here to connect my ComfyUI server to mobile app calling API and get respond. Let's open the API call setting part from clicking on API call icon from the left side. Here you have to give the API call name first and have to define the URL by which this API will post the request. In our case it will be Ngrok URL to call API, as I used local server HTTP address to make it public secure server, and that server will get the post request from mobile app text prompt data and send it to local ComfyUI server and respond as image URL link via HTTP secure server respond as base64 formatted image data to display the image in mobile app. This is the name of the text box of mobile app prompt controlled text box. This data will pass to JSON body workflow API formatted file, which will pass the text prompt to ComfyUI server. Data type is string. In the advanced setting have to turn on proxy run because many users use proxy server to hide their IP address, so string data can bypass proxy. And cache API results must be enabled also, as data might be transmitted part by part. That's all for this part. Let's move to the response and test tab, where you can check your API post is working or not. Here we will get back the respond via image URL, so it should mentioned on image underscore URL in JSON path and variable we already declared as name image URL. If everything is okay on API server, then test API call will return back some binary data here instead of image. Let's close this API call dialog box and go to the editor to show you how the interface of this mobile app was designed and how I set the different properties and action for every control and how I set the API variables to get the image data to in the image control of this mobile app. Designing mobile app interface is very easy and widget tree is very easy to understand, as it's maintain a clear flow of the controls. First home, under that a stack, then column, text, prompt text, button, image control and text for snake bar, which will show the different status of app in the down. App bar, which is now empty, and finally title cation text for mobile app in the top. Whenever you see the icon like arrow with path connection means there is some action on that control, so if you go to right side you can see the logo of action is looking same in the control in green color, if you want to define or want to watch action against that control or element. If you click on action icon button it will open new tab where you can open action flow editor that I mentioned before. Let's open the property page and check how it set the values for different controls. If you have previously experienced with any kind of HTML edit also this will very easy, but more details options for set the properties. Here you can set text or caption for each properties, set font size, padding, alignments for each controls and extra you can call to the API data and variables to connect with relevant controls. Just follow this part carefully where I am showing you how to set the different values for each control and elements. Most of the major controls you can define action and controls name, which you can later use in API call and bind later on the API variables to that control to send and receive values for that control. As here we will post and get respond the data via API, so our main settings will based on what we already did or mentioned on the API tab. I will show you action part also and explain what it will do when we run this app later part of this video. If you like my video please put a comment and share it. Let's go to Action tab and check how to set actions. As you see here, there are two actions already I defined, so let's click on Open button to open and check the Action Flow Editor. Action Flow Editor is like a flow chart where I have to define or choose one action and have to set the condition for true and false, means if results get what we will do and if results not get what we will do. There are many predefined action based on user's requirements, so if you can't see your required action, then you can search for it. Here I try to find the API call action and then set the values accordingly. I will request to the new user, please check some tutorial before you start working with Flutter Flow web app. At the same time, you can try to learn or navigate by your own, but don't save the action unless you are confident you did the right way to set up actions. No one knows your requirements better than you, so just try to find or write what exact data you want to get from API call or other action and check the API documentation for post, get and respond, and start defining values and set actions here. Here the scenario is very easy. It's a backend API call action which is a API request URL, here it is image URL. If successfully send the request, then nothing to do, but if false means API request failed, then can show message and show snack bar. Group or call name is test result API, the name we defined. Variable that will hold the prompt text defined also. And finally API request URL. We can send the data request by post command via URL only, so I try keep a naming convention for easy to understand. If you set the API name and variable name already in API tab, then you will see as under the drop-down list box and you have select the value from there properly. Action output variable name you have to type here, so please give a meaningful name so later on easy to recognize. Here conditional action name equals action variable name. As we tested, the API post respond already means I did already, so it's showing succeeded here. You can add many action here and set or call the values here depending on your mobile app scenarios. So far no code yet, only set the values and design by drag and drop only. Easy to learn up to this part, right? Now it's time to set the properties and values for image and other controls. You can adjust the padding and alignment and define the image type. I selected here network to show some default picture in image control, and later image will also come by internet URL via network. There is option for upload image assets and show default picture via URL also from other internet website or using existing image assets of other projects. Image format I want to keep auto, so it will support all popular formats. If you remembered, we set image URL variable in API, so here we will write the same name or can choose also by clicking on the icon next to text caption path. When you click the icon next to path, this side box will appear where you have to select the values showed here. As the data will come from API JSON format files, it will be JSON body. As API path is already set, so it will predefines path, and when you select it, the predefined path name that you defined before can see in the drop-down list box. Default variable value is image path showing here by Flutter Flow. You can check the other actions associates with the controls and create actions if require. That's all for today's video. In the next video, I will show you how to set the API server backend program by Python code where API request will be accepted. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to press bell icon to get notification. Thank you for your watching.